projectile, projectile. Position. The position of a point like P can be represented by coordinates. If it lies on a straight line, suppose O is initial position and from left to right direction, it is taken as positive, and P lies in this direction at a distance x, then the coordinate of P is said as x. It is nothing but the distance, straight line distance, from O to the point P along OX direction. By knowing this coordinate, we can locate this point P, that is its position. Instead of a line, if it lies beyond the line, then we say the point is in a plane. The point is in a plane. When it is in a plane, we require two coordinates to locate this point. One is O to A, it is called X coordinate. O to A distance is called X coordinate, and A to P distance is Y coordinate. So with XY coordinates, we can locate the point P in a plane. If the point P is in space, it requires three coordinates for locating this point P. Generally, we represent them as X, Y, Z. Position vector. The vector obtained by joining origin of the coordinate system to a point P is called its position vector. O to P is the position vector of P. O is tail, P is head. And this can be represented in terms of unit vectors. If the coordinates of point P are xy, if the coordinates of point P are xy, then xi is the x component of the position vector. Xi is the x component of position vector, and yj is y component of the position vector. Y component of the position vector of P. So the position vector of P can be represented. If it is represented by r bar, then r bar will be equal to xi plus yj. Xi plus yj. You know that x, y are coordinates, and I and j are unit vectors along x-axis and y-axis. Displacement vector. If two points P and Q are taken in a plane, the vector from P to Q is known as the displacement vector. The vector P to Q is the displacement vector from P to Q. Suppose the position vector of P is OP bar, that is R1 bar, and the position vector of Q is OQ bar, say it is R2 bar. Position vector of P is R1 bar, position vector of Q is R2 bar. Then the displacement vector PQ bar will be equal to, that is, let us represent it by delta R bar. The delta R bar will be equal to R2 bar minus R1 bar. R2 bar minus R1 bar. This is the displacement vector. Velocity. If the displacement vector is delta R bar, P is initial position, Q is final position, PQ is the displacement vector, that is, a particle starts at P and moves up to Q, then the displacement will be PQ bar, or it is represented by delta R bar. We have derived this, the relation between position vectors, delta R bar, as R2 bar minus R1 bar. Delta R bar is equal to R2 bar minus R1 bar. If delta T is the time taken for the particle to travel from P to Q, if delta T is the time taken by the particle to travel from P to Q, then delta R bar by delta T is known as the average velocity. Average velocity, total displacement by total time. If delta T is made as small as possible, then delta R will also become small. And delta R by delta T ratio, it reduces to a constant value. It moves towards a constant value. That is represented by limit delta R bar by delta T as delta T tends to 0. Limit delta R bar by delta T as delta T tends to 0. and this constant value is represented by dr by dt. The constant value is represented by dr by dt. This is known as the instantaneous velocity. Instantaneous velocity is equal to dr by dt, and it is obtained by limit delta r by delta t as delta t tends to 0. We know that we have already represented the position vector of r bar as xi plus yj. Position vector of r bar is represented by xi plus yj. So velocity will be equal to d by dt of xi plus yj, which is equal to dx by dt I plus dy by dt j. dx by dt I plus dy by dt j, which is equal to vxi plus vyj, This is the relation for velocity of the particle. Acceleration. Average acceleration is delta v bar by delta t. Delta v bar is change in velocity, and delta t is the time taken for change in velocity. So total change in velocity by total time is the definition of average acceleration. So relation for average acceleration is equal to delta v bar by delta t. If delta t is made as small as possible, then the limit delta v bar by delta t tends to a constant value, and it is written as limit delta v bar by delta t as delta t tends to 0. And this limiting value is represented by dv by dt, which is a constant. This constant value is termed as instantaneous acceleration. The relation for acceleration is dv bar by dt, but we have derived the relation for v bar as vxi plus vyj. Therefore, acceleration A is equal to d by dt of vxi plus vyj, d by dt of vxi plus vyj, which is equal to dvx by dti plus dvy by dtj. Dvx by dt is axi, dvy by dt is ayj, so acceleration A becomes equal to axi plus ayj. Equations of motion. We know the kinematic equations of motion are v is equal to u plus at, s is equal to ut plus half at square, v square minus u square is equal to 2as, sn is equal to u plus a into n minus half. When a projectile is traveling, its motion can be studied in two directions, one along x-axis, the other one along y-axis. While studying, we can apply these equations of motion in both the directions, that is along x-axis direction and along y-axis direction. By applying these equations in two perpendicular directions, we can find the resultant motion of the particle, that is the projectile. Path of projectile. The path of a projectile is a parabola, as shown in the figure OAB. OAB is path of a projectile. To understand this path of a projectile, let us consider a stone thrown up, not vertically upwards, at some angle. A cricket ball or a baseball hit by a bat. A bullet fired from a gun. A javelin thrown by an athlete. When we observe the motion of the stone thrown up, or the ball hit by bat, or the bullet, the motion of the bullet, and the motion of the javelin, we notice that they don't travel either in vertical direction or in horizontal direction. They travel in curved path. That curved path is the path of the projectile. It is nothing but a parabola, as shown in the figure OAB. The curve OAB represents the path followed by the projectile. So to understand the projectile, we have to observe, we have to imagine the motion of the stone thrown upwards, the ball hit by a bat, and the bullet fired from a gun, and the javelin thrown by an athlete. When we imagine their motion, their paths, we understand the path of a projectile. We represent mathematically a projectile by two parameters, its velocity of projection and angle of projection. So a projectile will be described with velocity of projection and angle of projection. Here the velocity of projection is u and the angle of projection is theta. U is making an angle theta with x-axis, with horizontal. Like this we describe a projectile. Definition of a projectile. A body thrown up at an angle other than 90 degrees with the horizontal is called a projectile. A body thrown up at an angle other than 90 degrees with the horizontal is called a projectile. In the figure, four directions are shown. 1, 2, 3, 4. The direction 4 is vertical projection. So generally, it will not be considered as a projectile. The other three directions, 1, 2, 3, are considered as projectiles. Their directions are projectiles. So, other than 90 degrees means any of these motions, 1, 2, 3, are in any other direction other than 90. Components of a vector. Components of a vector. If there is a vector r bar which is making an angle theta with x-axis, if there is a vector r bar making an angle theta with x-axis, then its x component is r cos theta, its x component is r cos theta, and y component is r sin theta. Y component is r sin theta. By applying this resolution of a vector to the projectile, the horizontal component becomes u cos theta and the vertical component becomes u sin theta. Horizontal component is u cos theta and vertical component is u sin theta. Like this, we resolve the initial velocity of the projectile into two components as x component and y component. We learn more about vectors in the chapter vectors, then it will be more clear.